Today we will make this procedural material without any tricky math, because we don't like math. This material is basically built up of two parts, the first part being the gradient part and the second being the circular dots. So let's start with how to create the gradient part first. So let's start off by creating the gradient first. For a gradient, what I like to do is I would like to add a empty plane axis in the middle of this and copy the rotation of the object. This way I can use this empty to drive the gradient. I'm going to select my gradient over here, hit Ctrl T so that I get the mapping and texture coordinate. I'm going to select this empty I have over here and use object. This way we can easily control the fall off of the gradient using only this null, and that is the kind of look I'm going for. So now we have our gradient. Now what I want to do is I want to make the dotted material. For that I'm going to take a Voronoi texture. Let's preview that. Right now it is completely stretched, so we have to fix that first. For that I'm going to select the Voronoi texture, Ctrl T, so that I get the texture coordinate and mapping node. And for all the shortcuts to work, make sure that you have the node wrangler add-on enabled. And from here I'm going to use our object coordinate. And right now you can see these are not dots exactly, right? So we have to make it into dots. For that I'm going to add a color ramp, put this over here, and we have to crush the dark and bright values somewhere over there. Okay, that looks good. And right now we have our gradient and our dot material as well. We have to mix these two together. For that I'm going to use the shortcut Ctrl Shift, right mouse button, and drag between the nodes I want to mix. I'm going to set factor 1, set this to difference. I usually try different blend options in the mix node to see which one works the best. For this one, it's difference. And now what I want to do is I want to use this as a mask to mask between two different materials. So we have our principal BSDF over here. I'm going to set that to an orangish color and also add a glass BSDF as well. And I have to mix these two together. For that, Ctrl Shift, right mouse button, and drag between the nodes I want to mix. And we get a mix shader over here. And I'm going to use our mask we just made earlier and plug that into the fact value, which gives us this. And definitely right now we are getting there. If you want to learn procedural texturing but without learning the complex math, then check out my course. You will find the link in the description. The gradient should be a bit more higher. And because I made the empty earlier, it is much more easier for me to control the gradient over here. And the best thing about using a procedural texture is the absolute control you get over your texture. If I want to increase the number of dots, I can increase the scale of my Voronoi texture. And if I want to decrease the size of my dots, I can come into our color ramp and crush the values. And also over here, I can easily come over here and try out different materials. And that is how I made this material completely procedurally inside of Blender. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more Blender tutorials.